In enterprise data management, you use requests to make changes to viewpoint data in a view. You can interactively make changes to viewpoints by manually adding items to a request. For bulk updates, you can use Microsoft Excel spreadsheets to upload request items from multiple worksheets into corresponding viewpoints in a view. And when you have multiple outstanding requests for a view, you can consolidate them into a single combined request. This enables approvers to review and approve all changes across multiple requests in bulk. This view contains viewpoints that correspond to three different applications. You can compare two viewpoints to find missing nodes and compare relationships and property values. I'll look for missing nodes. The comparison results display the missing nodes. Select a node in the results list to locate it in the first viewpoint. Notice that this is a parent node with children. To easily add the node and its children to the second viewpoint, create a request, then drag and drop the parent node from the first viewpoint to the second. When prompted, select Node and Children. When you're done, submit the request. The system automatically validates the request items, and the request is placed into the governance workflow with a status of in flight. The request items are not committed to the viewpoint until their data governance policies are satisfied with the required approvals and commits. Next, let's make mass updates to the view. When you need to make mass changes, it's a best practice to download the viewpoint to Excel, make updates in the spreadsheet, and then load the changes into a request. This workbook has three worksheets with names that correspond to the viewpoint names. The data in each worksheet will be loaded into the corresponding viewpoint. To load the request items, first create and name a request. Then, from the Request Action menu, select Load Request Items. I'll drag the file to the selection pane. A preview of the data in the first worksheet is displayed. Use the Sheets dropdown to preview other worksheets. By default, all worksheets in the file are selected for loading. Clear Load This Sheet to remove worksheets. Notice again that the worksheet names must match the viewpoint names. Load the data. When the load completes, a result summary displays the total number of rows that were loaded, the number of rows that were successfully processed, and the number of rows that were skipped. Any load errors are identified in the result summary. The request items are loaded from the file worksheets into the corresponding viewpoints. After the file is loaded, it is added as an attachment to the request. Two new columns are added to the file. Status displays load status for the row, such as success or skipped. Message provides additional information for the row, for example, the reason why a row was skipped. Submit the request. There are now two in-flight requests for the same view. Let's go to Request Activity. In the Request Inspector, you can view a summary of the request and the details of each request item. The Action menu for each request action gives you the option to delete the action. The Comments tab displays any user comments recorded for the request, and the Attachments tab lists worksheets used to load request items and any other attachments added by users before the request was submitted. On the Policies tab, you can review the policy execution plan for the request, which displays all approval and commit policies triggered by the request, along with the policy order. The Workflow tab shows the current state of the data governance workflow for the request. The Request Lineage tab shows requests related to the current request through subscription activity. Finally, the History tab lists the request history by user with timestamps. And the Audit tab lists all changes to nodes that have been committed with this request. As a user with data manager or higher permissions for all request items, you can consolidate in-flight requests for the same view. This aggregates items into a single consolidation request so that approvers can review and approve them in bulk. Select Requests to Consolidate, then click Consolidate Requests. Optionally, add the submitters of the original requests as collaborators on the consolidation request. When you consolidate requests, the source requests are marked as consolidated, locked for changes, and workflow on them is stopped. The new consolidation request is set to Draft, and the stage is set to Submit. When you inspect the consolidation request, you can select the Consolidation tab to view the requests that were consolidated. Open the consolidation request to perform draft request actions such as adding, editing, and deleting request items. When you submit the consolidation request, a new governance workflow is started for items that trigger policies configured to include the consolidation request type. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.